HR Puff and Steph. Who's your friend when things get rough? HR Puff and Steph. Can't do a little cause you can't do enough.
Once upon a summertime, just a dream from yesterday, a boy and his magic golden flute heard a boat from off the bay.
Come and play with me, Jimmy, come and play with me, and I will take you on a trip far across the sea.
Belonged to a cookie or witch who had in mind the flute to snitch.
From her broom broom in the skies, she watched her plans materialize. She waved her wand, the beautiful boat was gone. The skies grew dark, the sea grew rough, and the boat sailed on and on and on and on and on and on.
But Puff and Stuff was watching too and knew exactly what to do. He saw the witch's bold attack, and as the boy was fighting back,
he called his rescue racer crew, as often they'd rehearse, and off to save the boy they flew.
But who would get there first?
But now the boy had washed ashore, Puff arrived to save the day, which made the witch so mad and sore, she shook her fist and screamed away. HR Puff and Steph, who's your friend when things get rough? HR Puff and Steph, can't do a little cause you can't do enough. HR Puff and Steph, he's your friend when things get rough. HR Puff and Steph, can't do a little cause you can't do enough.
Marshall, Will and Holly, on a routine expedition, met the greatest earthquake ever known. High on the rapids, they struck their tiny raft, plunged them down 1,000 feet below, to the land of the lost. The land of the lost. Land of the lost.
Let me tell you a tale, a very scary tale about two boys who were surfing one day on a very weird beach round Dead Man's Point, where there are haunted sea caves, they say. And strange sea monsters have been sighted there. If you're traveling in the area, beware, 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 beware.
Sigmund, you're a rotten sea monster.
You're a disgrace to the family.
Go out and scare a human or you're through.
No.
Come on, come on.
Meanwhile, back on the beach, Johnny and Scott are combing the rocks, unaware that behind them Sigmund lurks, prepared to give them a shock. Boo! In total surprise, the boy's eye, this blob, what can it be? And then it groans and moves, and lo, it's a monster from the sea. Now Sigmund, the sea monster, and Johnny and Scott are friends, the finest friends that ever could be on the land or on the sea. Now Sigmund, the sea monster, and Johnny and Scott are friends, the finest of friends that ever could be on the land or on the sea.
The Bugaloos!
The Bugaloos, the Bugaloos, we're in the air and everywhere, flying high, flying loose, flying free as a summer breeze, happy as a summer breeze. The Bugaloos, we're in the air and everywhere.
Middle of a summer, in the middle of a park, there began a great adventure for a boy whose name was Mark. He had come to see the magic man along with all the
children, and 'twas so began the day that Dark was never to forget. He performed all sorts of miracles, and Mark was so impressed that when the time arrived to go, he lagged behind the rest. Then quietly he did return the secret of the hat to learn, but everyone had gone away, and Dark was held a threat. The moment that he touched the hat, the room began to glow, and as he put it down and ran, the hat began to grow and 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 grow. Stunned and he was fascinated, still he had to see there was something deep inside the hat. What could that something be? Then cautiously each step he took, he climbed up on the brim to look, and all at once the hat began to shake and rock. Look out!